Why won't these guys just come out and say that the next generation Challengers and Chargers coming in 2024 is going to have an inline six turbocharged engine with a plug-in hybrid drivetrain? There, I said it. Hold on, time out. Before you hit that dislike button in the masses and turn this video off, let me explain, right? Now, if you don't know who I am, look at this hat right here. I am mainly the guy to talk to when it comes to rear tire information. We're not trying to figure out where your build is coming, or figure out information from sources from the inside of the plan, or sources from inside of Mopar, or not really Mopar, but Stellantis now. But I'm also a former Challenger Hellcat owner. Back in 2016, I had me a 6-speed manual Challenger Hellcat. And then ever since then, I've been wanting to get another one. So I've been waiting. Well, I struck out and getting a Demon. So I'm not even gonna talk about that horror story. But last year, I was hoping to get a Challenger ACR, but the CEO of Dodge came out and said last year that the physics wasn't there to make a Challenger ACR, which, well, pretty much was bummed. But at least as a consolation prize, I got me a Ram TRX in the process. But enough of this fluff, man, let's get into this stuff. Now let's get into the current model for a second here. Now we know for a fact that for right now, there are three more production years left for the Challengers and Chargers. Look at this article right here. FCA, well then they was SCA before they turned to Stellantis, signed a 3-year agreement with Unifor. They agreed to make the Challenger Charger how it sits for 3 more years with 3 more variants coming. Now those variants, we don't know what they are, but I got a pretty good idea what they won't be, right? We won't see a new version of the Challenger Charger that will be faster than the Demon, because Dodge already came out when they came out with the Superstock and said to the media that they will not make a car faster than the Demon to piss off Demon owners. If you see with the Superstock, they made it 1 mile per hour slower, and it will not sell any Demon parts to people who own Superstocks. The only way you need to get Demon parts is you gotta have a VIN number. So we already got confirmation right there that they essentially neutered themselves into making a more powerful variant of the Challenger. Now that excludes them from making a Charger Demon. I don't know why Dodge, you guys, would not make a Charger Demon. Everyone probably would love to get one, essentially since people keep falling for the same old Easter egg every year, well, or April Fool's joke every year, of the SRT Ghoul, that people keep making all these fake videos that, oh man, they're saying they're gonna make it. It's gonna be that $200,000, blah, blah, blah. But whatever. Number two, we know it's not gonna be an ACR variant because they've already came out and said last year that the physics is not there to make an ACR variant of the Challenger. And it's probably gonna apply with the Charger too, right? And number three, more than likely, we're not gonna see a hybrid version of the car, a 4xe type system from the Wrangler in the Challenger and Charger until the swap over in 2024. Just saying. Let's go talk about the engine. Now, we already know from what the CEO of Dodge and I think the CEO of FCA or Stellantis of America, whatever, has already came out and said that the VA days are numbered, blah, blah, blah. Now, if you look at articles all over the place, back in 2020, right before they merged from PSA and FCA to Stellantis, the CEO had already said back in December that they are not going to be doing any updates to any internal combustion engines that are currently in production. So you pretty much go ahead and assume right there that the 5.7, the 392, and the 6.2 and the Hellcat will not be getting any updates. And they include the V6 Pentastar. I think the last time that was updated like in 2011. So that would be what, 13, 14 years of the same engine. There's no way they're going to keep that engine in production that long with these new platforms that are coming out, right? So I'll talk about that in a second. Now, the only thing you see happen over the last few years is seeing the engine name trademarked, you're seeing the CUDA name trademarked, you're seeing patents for the GME T6 engine, which is gonna be an inline six turbocharged engine, which I said earlier is gonna be in the Challengers and Chargers. And if you look at Mopar Insiders, they said that engine can have a couple different variants going all the way from 300 horsepower up to like the mid five. And that right there makes sense if you're gonna replace the Pentastar all the way up to the Hellcat engine. Well, final horsepower in the Hellcat engine. Instead of having three different engines serving three different cars, you can have one engine, detune it, and it'll take care of multiple different trim plates. Now, word about a campfire is, one of my sources is that plant that they're making in Indiana is gonna be the plant that's gonna actually start producing that engine. Now, plant is supposed to go online sometime this year. Look at this article right here. It states that for right now, the production in that plant is going to make that GME four-cylinder version. But I've heard from sources that it's going to be the four-cylinder and the six-cylinder version of this engine. Now, it makes sense for Stellantis to put this engine plant right there in Indiana, because it's going to be smack dab in the middle of all the production sites. If you know for right now, that the Hellcat engine is made down in Mexico and shipped all the way to Canada. Them putting this engine plant in Indiana puts it in a central location, because if they're gonna put this engine in the Jeeps, they got a Jeep plant in Toledo. Now, we all know that the Rams are made up in Shap and in Warren. That's right up the road from Indiana. We all know the Jeep Grand Cherokee and like the Grand Wagoneer, all that stuff is made between JNAP and the new Mack plant. Durango's made up there in JNAP. And then let's not forget up in Canada, the Brampton plant where the Challenger Charger currently made and the 300. And then right there in, what was that, Windsor, where they're making like the minivan for the Pacifica. Them putting that plant right there makes perfect sense if they're gonna replace the engine. But I'm just saying all that to say that is one reason why they are not going to continue the V8 platform and then also continue to update it, because they got to drop the cost of trying to update those vehicles. It's because all the engines are old. It's time for them to get updated, and they're all polluting. I mean, if you look at your window sticker right now, you'd be hard pressed to find one that has like a 4 on the window sticker unless it has a small engine in it, right? So it doesn't make sense for them to keep going along the same trend of keep making these polluting engines, because even with the e-torque system and like the with the 5.7 Hemi, that still is not a very great input, right? Or not input, but increase of fuel economy. As far as the Hellcat comes concerned, that's where we get into all the hybrid stuff. Now, if you look at this article right here, they've already placed an order through ZF Transmissions to have a hybrid transmission from there. And if you look at this article by Auto Evolution, you'll see their support to electric motor up to 300 horsepower. So essentially, if they have a 500 horsepower engine and 300 horsepower motor or electric motor, you'll see that you can get up to 800 horsepower with a plug-in hybrid version of the car. Now, if you look what Ralph Giles said on a podcast, he said that the future of the Hellcat platform is essentially with plug-in hybrids, with gas and electric motors that could potentially drive the new version of Hellcat up to 1,000 horsepower. So we might not see 1,000 horsepower at the beginning. We know that it's coming. Now, I don't know if you're this podcast or none of them, but he essentially said that all the current engineers is dedicated to EV platforms. So we got three validations from pretty much the top three people. They have all said V8 is gone, no updates, and everyone's working on EV offerings.
It may not be in the way that you think. It might be a combination of electrification and gas, which eventually they'll probably be pure electrics. But in the meantime, we're getting from both worlds, because manufacturers are turning their attention to electrification, as we are too. We're investing a lot in that. We're not developing gas as much. We're turning most of our engineers into electrification engineers.
Now, if you look at this chart right here, the CEO of Stellantis came out, it was what, I think April 15th, and showed this image right here of how all the platforms are going to be moving over to four simple ones by 2024. The Challengers and Chargers are going to be on that, probably that C and D platform. By 2025, 96% of the U.S. market will have an LEV offering. Now, the LEV offering basically means to him that you either have a plug-in hybrid version or it's going to have an electric hybrid version, right? And so by 2025, they expect for 30% of all the vehicles sold in the U.S. by them will be either one of those two variants. And then by 2029, every single vehicle will have only an electric version, and they're going to phase out the plug-in hybrid. So essentially what they're doing is they're going to come out with plug-in hybrid versions of a car. They kind of get us comfortable with having EVs and then phase them out by 2029 to strictly fully electric. So that literally buys them time to get the battery technology up. Now, if you look at this graph, the most aggressive curve is going to be between 2023 and 2025. And essentially, that's important because right there in 2024, that's when we're hearing that the new Challenger Charger going to come out. And we're also hearing that the new Ram 1500 redesign will come out around that same time. So that's where you're going to see, if they just electrify those two models, essentially three models, the Ram 1500, the Challenger, and the Charger, that's a lot of trim packages underneath that vehicle. And that gives them a lot of ability to make a lot of electric vehicles within a short time. Pretty much what we're seeing is that the new Challenger and Charger in 2024 is going to have a plug-in hybrid version. And then it might have a full electric version. Now, it might not be a Hellcat variant that might come out. It might be, you know, a few years down the road, but we know by 2029, there will be an all-electric Challenger by 2029. It is guaranteed to happen. Now, me personally, I think this crap sucks, but that's apparently what it seems is going to happen. So, Stellantis is trying to decrease their costs as much as possible to be able to afford to bring out these new models. So, the Challenger and Charger, that's why all these next three variants, I do not expect real major changes to them. I don't expect them to go hybrid. We already know there would not be a variant higher than the Demon, right? And then I don't expect it to be anything really more than maybe a Charger Demon and maybe two trim plates, maybe like two final edition versions of the Challenger, right? Because what is the point of making another Hellcat variant of the Challenger and Charger if it's not gonna be faster than the Demon? Other than making a Charger Demon, only thing you can really do is make a Charger Super Stop, which, I mean, it's essentially going to be damn pointless. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, people want faster Hellcats, but they just can't do it because they already said they're not going to do it. Now, I got my fingers crossed that one of those variants will be a Charger Demon because it only makes sense, Dodge. I was so pissed off I wasn't able to get a Challenger Demon. Even though I don't particularly like the Chargers, I will get one just because it's a demon. Because it doesn't make sense that you guys now got a wide body and a red eye version and don't make a Charger Demon. You don't even make a superstar version of the Charger, right? So hopefully I can get information about these three new variants. And if I do, I'll put them up here in this playlist right here. Now in this playlist is gonna have a bunch of information about all these new vehicles coming out. So make sure you guys do a brother a favor, subscribe to the channel. Because one important date to note is July 8th. Because July 8th, the CEO Stellantis is gonna detail all the information about all these hybrids that will be popping up by 2025. So when that information comes available, I'm gonna make a video about it and break it down. So I'm gonna have more videos about the hybrid coming out, the engine, the Turbo 6 engine. I'm gonna have more information about potentially a electric Viper coming, because there's an interview by Ralph Giles to not get into, but I'll do that in another video. So make sure you stay tuned, like I said earlier. But I want to know, if they made a six-cylinder turbo Challenger, would you buy it? Especially if it was like 500 horsepower. It would be faster than the current 392. It'd be lighter than the current 392. Would you buy a hybrid version of the Challenger and Charger if it was a Hellcat with a six-cylinder with a hybrid engine in it? If it sounded like the Ford GT, would you buy it? Let me know down in the comments down below. And so that's it for this video, guys. Make sure you help a brother out with a like and subscribe. And until the next video,